No, I never heard about Maharaja Duleep Singh.
No, I haven't heard much about him.
No, I have not heard of Maharaj Duleep Singh.
Yeah, I did heard, but I don't know any history.
I've heard of his name, but I don't know much about him.
I studied in a Hindu school, so it's like DAV public school. So the history which was being delivered to it was most like Ashoka or the other world wars which were going on, but no mention was given regarding the Maharaja Duleep Singh or any Sikh history.
Let's find out a little more about Maharaja Duleep Singh and the experience of the Sikh community in Scotland.
He was born on the 16th of September 1838 in the city of Lahore.
His father, Maharaja Ranjit Singh, a successful and influential king who kept the British at bay for 50 years.
He passed away when Maharaja Duleep Singh was only 10 months old.
At the age of 5, Maharaja Duleep Singh was proclaimed the Prince of Punjab.
Following the First Anglo-Sikh War on March 1846, Maharaja Duleep Singh, aged 7, signed a peace treaty with the British,
not knowing his full control and power will be taken from him.
On August 1846, the Maharaja's mother was exiled to Sheikhpura, removing all of the Maharaja's influence and heritage.
By the age of 11, he lost his parents, his land, and his identity.
Isolated, vulnerable, and alone in the world.
I came to Scotland in 1975. When I was leaving my family, I was very sad leaving them. I didn't know when I'll be going back to see them, so I was very sad.
My seat is a book, and India and China war start in 62. So my granddad canceled the ticket. He said, you know, go and fly, and the case plane fell down.
I was really upset because I was a headmistress in Delhi. My life was very active, lots of people, my family, my everything.
I was in India, I was just about less than 12 years old, but when my father said, I'm going to bring you to UK, I said, the flight in the plane, oh, I'm going to ride in a plane.
To be honest, it was very, very hard to come to a totally different, entirely different country, because traditions are different here, customs are different.
When I came here, so different people, different atmospheres.
So I tried to join the army. I done a 3-year training to army. They know take me because I'm only 15 years old.
The winter was very hard because we were not used to this kind of climate.
When I come in this country, I never see a sun.
And people were very, very helpful because there are certain things which are pronounced differently in this country. Like in India, they used to call curd, but here they call it yogurt.
So that was my reason for coming. I just wanted to ride in the plane.
Somebody came to my shop and he says to me, Surinder, give me a bra onion. And I couldn't understand. And I say to him, I said, Eric, I know you want an onion, but what kind of onion, I don't know. And he just laughed and he said, bra means a very good one.
Maharaja Duleep Singh would have felt very sad, but obviously he didn't have a choice. He didn't know he was coming to this country. Basically, he was forced to come.
With Maharaja Duleep Singh's mother exiled, Sir John Logan becomes the legal guardian of the young prince.
In 1849, he was deposed as the last king of Punjab and exiled to Fatehgarh.
In 1853, under the guidance of Sir John Logan and the encouragement from Queen Victoria, Maharaja Duleep Singh conveyed Christianity at the age of 15.
In 1854, Maharaja Duleep Singh cuts his hair.
This was the final stage of removing Maharaja Duleep Singh from his faith, identity and past.
In 1857, he moves to Castle Menzies, Perthshire, Scotland. This becomes his temporary home, a beautiful yet isolated place.
Maharaja Duleep Singh attempts to meet his mother on numerous occasions, but is refused entry to his home in Punjab.
He arrives in India in January 1861, when he meets his mother, Queen Jind Kaur, after a period of 13 years.
His mother doubts her son has returned because of his unshorn hair and changed appearance.
The Maharaja and his mother are forced back to England by the British government.
For the next 4 years, they reconciled, bringing back long-lost memories, his beliefs and his roots.
You miss your parents and you have left all of your family,
the whole life where you have basically grown up, you're going to leave that apart and you're starting your new life and totally new culture.
Any child who would be at that age, a mother is a guide for that person, and a mother is someone who can nurture.
My mom's everything for me, like she's my lifeline, my guide. She made me do what she couldn't do.
Gurudev Mata, Gurudev Pita. The first word they've used is mother. That mother is your teacher, mother is your guru.
In 1863, his mother passes away. Now left with no parents, he's truly lost.
The Maharani, by her death, had sown the seeds of discontent, and in Duleep Singh's mind, these would influence his actions later in life.
He had connected with his cousin Thakur Singh, who arrived in England in 1884 with a Sikh priest and a calligrapher, who had written one of the very first handwritten copies of Guru Granth Sahib Ji.
The Maharaja expresses his desire to go back to India and be reinitiated into the Sikh faith.
The Maharaja then leaves for India with his wife and six kids. However, his trip comes to a quick halt as the Maharaja is arrested at Aden, being informed that he's not permitted by the government of India to proceed any further.
May 25th, 1886 was an inspiring time when he rejoined the Sikh faith after a religious ceremony in Yemen.
After a series of struggles attempting to return home, Maharaja Duleep Singh arrives in Paris. After 3 years of ill health, the last sovereign of the Sikh Kingdom of Punjab passes away at the age of 55 in a hotel in Paris, alone. His final wish to be cremated in India was denied. He was laid to rest in England.
Being a Scottish Sikh is important, especially for me, to know about Maharaja Duleep Singh's history, because he was the first Scottish Sikh and he was the last Prince of Punjab, and it's important to establish this connection between Scotland and Punjab.
Maharaja Duleep Singh, he came here when he was quite young. He was the first Sikh who came and no one was here. His family was like in India and he didn't have any relatives, and there was no gurdwaras, and like he can't worship the Guru Granth Sahib Ji. He was like lost, no family, and his whole family was like gone.
I came here when I was 8 with my family, and it was really different for me because I had to learn a different language and I had to make different friends, some non-Sikhs and some Sikhs.
For me, being a Sikh in Scotland provides me with a strong identity and a very unique identity, and I like being a Sikh in Scotland because we've got a very close-knit community.
So I go through like Sikhi classes and I get knowledge about Sikhs, why do they keep their hair, what did they do for us in the past.
A story that was hidden.
A life not remembered.
Until now.